Today we're taking a look at these MLB matches, which are happening on Monday, May 9, 2022. And giving you match breakdowns, betting tips and predictions in general on these games. Welcome back to High Stakes, let's get straight into it. Also, don't forget to subscribe to get notified as soon as we release these sport prediction videos, and if you would like more betting tips and predictions, then check out our Patreon in the link down below. Our new Patreon is a way for us to help you improve your chances of making more money. Multiple plans are available for each and every one of you. You can get 30 extra betting picks all the way up to 500 extra betting picks per month. Stop wasting hours of your time searching for bad betting picks that ends up costing you a lot of money. Join the High Stakes Patreon now and get the best betting picks. Los Angeles Angels vs Tampa Bay Rays. Our team pick is Tampa Bay Rays minus 1.5 runs, and here is why. On the defensive side of the field, the Angels have also been solid. They are only allowing 3.54 runs per game and have a combined team whip rating of 1.11. This is the 13th least amount of runs given up per game and the 4th lowest overall whip rating. They are doing a great job of keeping the opposing team off the base paths, as it is very tough to score when they have no base runners. The Angels have also relied on their starting pitching throughout the beginning of this season. They have recorded 9 quality starts, which is the 11th most in the league. They aren't having to rely on their bullpen, and it is keeping them very fresh for when the Angels need them to most. The Angels have already committed 16 fielding errors this season, as well. This is the 22nd most mistakes committed in the field, as the Angels would look much better if they eliminated these mistakes. According to MLB.com, Noah Syndergaard will be getting the start on the mound in this one. He has started this season 2-1 with a 2.63 ERA. He also only has a 0.96 whip rating. He is keeping his opponents from reaching base and making it very hard to score. I expect him to go deep into this game and give his team a chance at winning. On the defensive side of the field, the Rays have also been playing very well. They are allowing the 8th least amount of runs per game and also have the 3rd lowest overall team whip rating. Tampa Bay is only allowing 3.34 runs per game and has a 1.10 whip rating. Not many hitters are reaching base against the Rays' starting pitchers, and it is making it very difficult for them to score. Surprisingly, they have also only recorded 5 quality starts this season. Their bullpen has stepped up multiple times this season, and they will continue to battle for the Rays if they have to pull their starter early. The only thing that the Rays must take care of is the fielding errors. They have already committed 16 this season, which is the 23rd most in the league. According to MLB.com, Corey Kluber will be getting the start on the mound in this one. He has started this season 1-1 with a 2.36 ERA. He also has a 1.05 whip rating, as he has looked dominant in his first few starts. He is attacking each hitter and showing that he can strike multiple men out. He has already struck out 25 batters and will be looking for more in this one. The Tampa Bay Rays are coming into this series after taking 3 games from the Seattle Mariners and 3 more from the Oakland Athletics. They will be attempting to make it 4 wins against the Mariners on Sunday. The Rays are winning every game they play right now, and I just can't bet against them. They have one of the hottest defenses in the league, as they are scoring the 8th most runs per game and have the 5th highest overall team batting average. They will put the ball in play against Syndergaard and consistently score runs throughout this game. I also see Corey Kluber performing at a high level in this matchup. He currently only has a 1.05 whip rating and a 2.36 ERA. He will hold the Angels on the offensive side of the field as they struggle when they aren't hitting multiple bombs per game. Kluber will limit the number of home runs the Angels hit, and the Tampa Bay Rays will cover the run line spread, minus 1.5. Tampa has now won 2 series in a row, and I expect them to attempt to make it 3. Our total pick is, under the total. The Los Angeles Angels are looking to make a significant jump after having a good 2021 season, but missing the playoffs and adding talent in the offseason. Seattle has been dominant this season as they are 3rd in MLB with a 0.727 OPS as a team and have scored 4.63 runs per game thus far. Right fielder Taylor Ward might be the best hitter so far this season as he has a 1.165 OPS with 6 home runs, 15 RBI, and 20 runs scored with 19 walks and 21 strikeouts. Seattle Mariners vs Philadelphia Phillies. Our team pick is Philadelphia Phillies for the win. And here is why. Philadelphia will start left-hander Ranger Suarez. The lefty is 2-1 with a 4.63 ERA in 5 starts. The numbers have not been pretty for the left-hander, as he has allowed 28 hits, 10 walks, and 4 home runs in 23.1 innings pitched, striking out 15. That gives him a 0.295 opponent batting average and a 1.63 whip, as Suarez has yet to go past the 6th inning in any of his 5 starts. That puts the onus on this Philadelphia bullpen, who have not been very good this season, 25th in ERA at 4.36. The Phillies' bullpen has allowed 10 home runs in 95.0 innings and are 4-5. Philadelphia is averaging 4.66 runs per game, 9th overall, thanks to a potent lineup that is 4th in ops, .726, and 9th in home runs with 29. The average is not pretty for Kyle Schwarber, but he leads the club with 7 homers and 16 runs driven in. Bryce Harper has 6 home runs and leads the club with 19 RBI. The club will be looking for better results out of Chris Flexen. The right-hander has been snake-bitten so far this season, posting a solid 3.10 ERA in 5 starts, but is 1-4. Flexen has allowed 3 earned runs in his last 11.2 innings, but is 0-2 in those 2 starts. The club is simply not providing any offense for him, and the bullpen has faltered when called upon to finish off contests. The Mariners' bullpen is 20th with a 3.70 ERA, giving up 14 home runs in 99.2 innings pitched. Nick Castellanos is batting .308 to lead Philadelphia, and the left fielder has team highs in hits with 28 and on-base percentage at .79. Designated hitter Kyle Schwarber is the leader in home runs with 7, and right fielder Bryce Harper is the leader in RBIs with 17. On Monday, the Philadelphia Phillies will send Ranger Suarez to the mound. The left-hander is 2-1 with a 4.63 ERA, 15 Ks and 10 BBs. Seattle dropped to 12-16 following its 8-2 loss to the Tampa Bay Rays on Saturday. Seattle has lost each of the first 3 games of its 4-game series with Tampa Bay and will be swept with a loss on Sunday. Seattle has lost 6 straight and 10 of the last 11. The Mariners are 3rd in the American League West, 5.5 games behind the first-place Los Angeles Angels. J.P. Crawford is batting .340 to lead Seattle, and the shortstop has a team-high .435 on-base percentage. Third baseman Eugenio Suarez is the leader in home runs with 6, while third baseman Ty France is the leader in RBIs with 21, and hits with 36. Seattle has not yet announced its starting pitcher for Monday's opening game of a 3-game series against Philadelphia. Seattle is 15th in runs per game at 4.28, but they are simply not producing enough run support of late, producing 14 total runs through the 6-game losing streak. Seattle does have a lot of power, tied for 8th in home runs with 30, led by Eugenio Suarez with 6 homers. Ty France has 5 home runs and leads the club with 21 RBI. Our total pick is over 7.5 runs. Philly lost 8-7 to the Mets back on Thursday, but couldn't play again until a Sunday doubleheader. In those games, the Phillies posted a 3-2 win in the early outing. Game 2 didn't go so well for Philly, though, they fell 6-1 with 6 team hits and an error. For the starter gig in the Monday game, the Phillies are going with Ranger Suarez. In 5 starts this year, Suarez is 2-1 with a 4.63 ERA. In 23.1 innings of work total, he's put up 28 hits, 12 earned, 10 walks and 15 Ks. Seattle Mariners vs. Philadelphia Phillies. Our team pick is Philadelphia Phillies for the win. And here is why. Philadelphia will start left-hander Ranger Suarez. The lefty is 2-1 with a 4.63 ERA in 5 starts. The numbers have not been pretty for the left-hander, as he has allowed 28 hits, 10 walks, and 4 home runs in 23.1 innings pitched, striking out 15. That gives him a .295 opponent batting average and a 1.63 whip, as Suarez has yet to go past the 6th inning in any of his 5 starts. That puts the onus on this Philadelphia bullpen, who have not been very good this season, 25th in ERA at 4.36. The Phillies' bullpen has allowed 10 home runs in 95.0 innings and are 4-5. Philadelphia is averaging 4.66 runs per game, 9th overall, thanks to a potent lineup that is 4th in ops, .726, and 9th in home runs with 29. The average is not pretty for Kyle Schwarber, but he leads the club with 7 homers and 16 runs driven in. Bryce Harper has 6 home runs and leads the club with 19 RBI. The club will be looking for better results out of Chris Flexen. The right-hander has been snake-bitten so far this season, posting a solid 3.10 ERA in 5 starts, but is 1-4. Flexen has allowed 3 earned runs in his last 11.2 innings, but is 0-2 in those 2 starts. The club is simply not providing any offense for him, and the bullpen has faltered when called upon to finish off contests. The Mariners' bullpen is 20th with a 3.70 ERA, giving up 14 home runs in 99.2 innings pitched. Nick Castellanos is batting .308 to lead Philadelphia, and the left fielder has team highs in hits with 28 and on-base percentage at .79. Designated hitter Kyle Schwarber is the leader in home runs with 7, and right fielder Bryce Harper is the leader in RBIs with 17. On Monday, the Philadelphia Phillies will send Ranger Suarez to the mound. The left-hander is 2-1 with a 4.63 ERA, 15 Ks and 10 BBs. Seattle dropped to 12-16 following its 8-2 loss to the Tampa Bay Rays on Saturday. Seattle has lost each of the first three games of its four-game series with Tampa Bay and will be swept with a loss on Sunday. Seattle has lost six straight and 10 of the last 11. The Mariners are third in the American League West, 5.5 games behind the first-place Los Angeles Angels. J.P. Crawford is batting .340 to lead Seattle, and the shortstop has a team-high .435 on-base percentage. Third baseman Eugenio Suarez is the leader in home runs with 6, while third baseman Ty France is the leader in RBIs with 21, and hits with 36. Seattle has not yet announced its starting pitcher for Monday's opening game of a three-game series against Philadelphia. Seattle is 15th in runs per game at 4.28, but they are simply not producing enough run support of late, producing 14 total runs through the six-game losing streak. Seattle does have a lot of power, tied for 8th in home runs with 30, led by Eugenio Suarez with 6 homers. Ty France has 5 home runs and leads the club with 21 RBI. Our total pick is over 7.5 runs. Philly lost 8-7 to the Mets back on Thursday, but couldn't play again until a Sunday doubleheader. In those games, the Phillies posted a 3-2 win in the early outing. Game 2 didn't go so well for Philly, though, they fell 6-1 with 6 team hits and an error. For the starter gig in the Monday game, the Phillies are going with Ranger Suarez. In 5 starts this year, Suarez is 2-1 with a 4.63 ERA. In 23.1 innings of work total, he's put up 28 hits, 12 earned, 10 walks and 15 Ks. Disclaimer, no financial advice. The information on this channel is provided for education and informational purposes only, without any express or implied warranty of any kind, including warranties of accuracy, completeness, or fitness for any particular purpose. The information contained in or provided from or through this channel is not intended to be and does not constitute financial advice, investment advice, trading advice or any other advice. The information on this channel and provided from or through this channel is general in nature and is not specific to you, the user, or anyone else. You should not make any decision, financial, investment, trading or otherwise, based on any of the information presented on this channel without undertaking independent due diligence and consultation with a professional broker or financial advisory.